trying to find us. Telvika, wait. We have to open this hatch. Hold this. This is the way out.
So why aren't you closing the hatch?
Let them think we fled through here. There is another hatch near the city wall. We're going there. Hurry, let's go.
You wait here.
Search over there. Why, hello. If I am not mistaken, you are the wives of the Highnesses who have escaped. So, what are you doing here?
Are we committing a crime?
No, no. It is not a crime. But it could be a sign that your husbands are also here.
When we are together, we can console one another and tolerate this calamity a little better.
I hope this is the real reason for your being here. Come with me. Search everywhere. Search everywhere. Did you find them?
No, sir. It seems they're not here.
This door will not open.
Where does this door lead?
There. There is nothing, Your Highness. It is the library.
Open the door.
I told you. There is nothing there. It's just the library. You see, Your Highness, this is just a library.
Move this bookshelf aside. Torch.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
They live through here.
No. Three of you stay here, and the rest follow me. We cannot let them get away. Hurry, faster, come on. climb up. They're undoubtedly still in town. They won't get away from me. Follow me. Leave Galoos. Go. God be with you. Your Highnesses, did you see how great God is?
But now, which way do we go?
For now, we'll head towards the forest. We must leave before they find us. Let's go.
No, no. Bring the rope with you. If they find it, they will trace it back to us. Let's go.
So? Oh, thank you, dear God. Thanks be to you, God.
Lady Helen, I have good news. They even managed to climb the wall.
Thank God.
They say Phidias has helped the prisoners flee and has wounded Matthias.
Where is Phidias now?
He was killed. And the prisoners have used the opportunity to escape.
Those scoundrels. Julius. What news is there?
I traced them to Maximilian's home.
The result?
We arrived too late. They escaped through a secret passage at Maximilian's home.
They escaped. They cannot leave the city overnight, Julius. They must be brought back here before the Emperor wakes us in the morning.
Yes, sir.
City? Oh, no. What do I tell the Emperor in the morning? Oh, no.
We have searched all the houses in this neighborhood, Your Highness, and they are nowhere to be found.
Your Highness, we've searched the entire house. There's no one here.
Tonight, we must search each of their houses, as well as their families' houses. Let's go to Yuvanus' house. Ah!
deeper to the grate. If we find them, I will sacrifice a dog in front of your temple tomorrow.
Hey!
First, we must get as far away as possible, and then we can decide where to go.
There are a lot of places to hide in this very forest.
No, they will search each and every inch of this forest tomorrow.
Hold on a moment. Let me see. Do you know a village by the name of Rakim?
Yes. A Jewish spy told us about that village.
His name was Azoil. He said he saw you praying in a cave there. What is the story of this Jew?
He was a Jewish spy who was unfortunate enough to fall into our hands. We discovered he knew too much, so we took care of him and made sure he takes his information to the grave.
So it was you who stole Pluton's body and destroyed the sculptures in the temple? Also,
we felt we had to do something.
Yes. Let's go.
Let's go. Stop. You go that way. And you, go in that direction. The rest of you, follow me. How do you know this shepherd, Maximilian?
I have only known him for a short while, but it feels as if we have known each other for years.
Do you think this shepherd's home is a safe place for us to hide?
Yes.
This is unusual. Dogs usually bark at strangers, but this dog is quiet.
Maybe this is because it has seen me once before with its owner.
Who is it this early in the morning?
That is Antonius.
I'm coming!
You. Your Highness, Maximilian. What are you doing here?
Greetings to the honest Antonius. Do you want uninvited guests?
This hut is not worthy of such prestigious guests. Look, welcome to my humble abode. Please, grace me with your presence, please. Oh, come
inside.
In, please.
Go inside.
Welcome. Welcome. Oh, welcome.
Clear the way.
Are you all Maximilian's fellow believers?
What religion does Maximilian adhere to?
Oh, God, whatever I said. Oh, what I meant was me.
Don't be afraid, Antonius. Don't be afraid. These are all my friends. Tomika, Martinus, Iovannis, Sodinonus, and Denasius.
I thought for a moment that I'd given away Maximilian's secret in front of strangers. Anyway, welcome. Everything I have, I offer to you. Please forgive my humble offerings.
We are honored to be guests of Antonius, the kind and pure.
Oh, how I wish my father were alive to see so many noblemen embrace his religion. Do not tell me that Diocletian is Christian as well.
It is best that we tell you the reason why we're here.
Please, go ahead.
We are not here as guests. In truth, we are fugitives. We are fleeing Diocletian and his guards.
You have escaped? What crime have you committed?
Offending the Emperor and the gods of Rome.
Yesterday, in the presence of the Emperor, we voiced our beliefs and ruined the festivities being held in his honor.
No, I cannot believe this. You defied the Emperor.
Mm.
How did you escape? How is it possible to flee from that many guards?
It is a long story. I told my friends you might be able to help us.
Me? Yes, yes. I would be honored to be able to help Maximilian and your highnesses.
We are all advisors to Diocletian. Do you know what the punishment is for helping and harboring the Emperor's enemies?
Whatever it is, I am not hesitant. Providing a hideout for my dear, brave friends is the least that I can do.
But I think our staying here is dangerous for Antonius. Philadelphia is not far from here. I am certain the guards will be here by tomorrow.
You won't be able to leave the Emperor's territory, even if you travel on foot for an entire month. During the several days that I went to meet Maximilian in the cave, I learned so many things from him. And I was so charmed by his character that I am prepared to accept any danger to help him and his friends. You can stay here in this humble hut for as long as you wish. As you can see, I live here alone.
Antonius, why do you live alone? Where are your wife and children, your family?
I do not have a wife or children. Actually, I did want to get married. But every home that I went to, well, they told me they would only grant their sheep to me, not their daughters. Our daughters are not sheep. That's what they said to me. They thought that I wanted to take their daughters with me through the desert with my sheep.
Now that you have detached yourself from those who worship other than God, take refuge in a cave so your Creator can bestow his mercy upon you and set things right.
What is going on? What has happened to Maximilian?
Maximilian, you seem to be deep in thought.
Take refuge in a cave, so your creator can bestow his mercy upon you. And set things right.
Cave? What made you think of a cave?
I do not know. But something within me tells me we must take refuge in the cave.
Where is this cave that you're speaking of?
The same place I always go. Mount Angelos. The nearby mountain.
Is it safe there?
We have to get going. Perhaps he who guides us has put this thought in my head.
The villagers are beginning to wake. They will see you. Stay here until evening.
If we stay until evening, the guards will arrive.
Who can that be?
Quiet.
Don't worry. It's probably one of the villagers wanting to know why I'm late. Help yourself to some milk. I'll answer the door.
I'm coming.
Antonius, where were you? Did you fall asleep?
Why, what's happened?
What has happened? The villagers have brought their cattle out of their homes and are waiting for you. Are you not going to the desert today?
Oh, yes. Yes, I am. You go ahead. I'll be along shortly.
So hurry up.
You go so they don't have to wait any longer. And I'll come shortly. Go.
Who was it?
It was one of the villagers. I sent him away. Before the sun rises fully, we can leave. And if you allow me, I will come with you.
Hey, why do you want to join us? Is it really necessary to put yourself in danger?
I didn't have the chance to destroy the idols. The least I can do is join those who did. And anyway, you will be in need of a good servant.
You are our friend and brother. There is no reason for you to come with us. You have committed no crime.
I have only just found you. I cannot let you go so easily.
We will not take you with us. For you to insist is useless.
It would make us happy for you to join us. But if arrested, you will be stoned to death. Why do you want to be stoned without good reason?
Friends, we will leave one at a time. I will leave first. I will watch from the mountaintop to make sure you do not lose your way. Antonius, God be with you.
God be with you, Your Highness.
God be with you, Antonius the Shepherd.
God be with you.
Goodbye.
God be with you.
Farewell.
Goodbye.
God be with you.
God be with you.
Thank you. Stop! A few of you must go thoroughly search the underground chambers. The rest of you watch the perimeter. Get going! Quickly!
There is nobody here. There's nothing here.
Go, let's go.
There's no one there, sir.
Sanctus, you and one other soldier must head in that direction. And you go that way. And the rest of you follow me. Get going.
What is this? Who are those people climbing the mountain? Where are they going? They are strangers. Hey, go, animal.
Hey! Yeah!
See how they refused to take me with them. They were worried for my life. Is my life really worth worrying about? No, no, I do not think so. We must be worthy to travel alongside men of God. And I am unworthy. They are willing to sacrifice their lives in the name of God. Their path is the path of God. But I must focus on my existence and busy myself with this meaningless life. Kitmir, they have turned their backs on the false gods and idols and are heading towards the one God. But I have anchored myself to this world. I think if I had insisted, they would have agreed to take me with them. Do you not think so, Kitmir? Do you think it is a good idea to follow them? It is true that you are an animal and you do not have the ability to decide. It is only natural that you shake your head without knowing why.
But I have the ability to know the difference. I know that their path is the path of God. So why am I sitting here? I must go. Kitmir, you must stay here. You must take care of the sheep until their owners come for them. Kitmir, go! Go! Go back! Go! Why are you following me? Go back!
Why don't you listen to what I tell you? Go back, Kitmir. You must look after the sheep. Please go back. The herd needs you. Go back. Go, Kitmir. Go back. The herd is alone. Go. Go.
Sit down. Sit down. Give me your hand.
How did you find this place? Couldn't you find any place nearer than this for worshipping?
Does His Highness Maximilian know something we do not?
I don't know either. All I know is that there is a sign from God leading us this way. This cave does not lead anywhere. If our enemies arrive, we will have nowhere to escape. But in my heart, I'm certain.
You chose the most difficult path to find a place to be alone with God.
The path to God is never easy.
But Maximilian, it seems you did not choose this path on your own. There is another force guiding us along this path.
Dear God, how is it that you speak with us humans? How can a worthless human being be addressed by you?
I feel we are not treading this path of our own free will.
Yes, that is the case. I think we ought to get going. Antonius,
Your
what
Highness,
are you doing here?
If you want to know the truth, when you bid me stay behind, I turned to God. I got permission from Him.
Did God Himself tell you to come here?
He did. He told me Himself. He told me to take the path of the pious. But the pious would not take me with them along their path. So I had no choice. I had to take a shortcut.
And you reached the destination sooner, huh?
I did not intend to overtake you, but I had no other choice.
So you made your own choice in the end. All right. If you are asking for trouble, then so be it. You can stay with us.
Thank you. It's Kitmir. Kitmir, leave. Kitmir, why did you come here? Go back, why did you come? Didn't I tell you to stay with the herd?
It appears this dog will reveal our hideout.
Why won't you go, Kitmir? I'm commanding you, go back. It's so bizarre. Why won't he listen to my orders?
No, no. Don't hit him, Antonius. Let him come. Perhaps he is receiving his orders from someone else today. How can we be sure he is not looking for the same person we are? Do you think his belief in God is less than yours, Antonius? Leave him be.
Kitmir, come. Come. Come, come.
So, Maximilian's sanctuary is not bad.
It is deep and vast as well.
There is an exit over there.
No, it's just a hole that's been closed.
So this cave leads nowhere?
Yes, nowhere.
I already told you.
This is the place where they would meet and plot. This is where they would equip themselves and set out to carry out their schemes.
You mean they hunted with these bows and arrows?
Yes, they did. But their prey was Roman soldiers, not animals.
They hid their identity with these.
Mount your horse. Let's go. Search all of the surrounding villages and hideouts. Leave no stone unturned.
You are lying, Helen. You are lying. How do you expect me to believe that you do not know where they are hiding?
You can see I don't know.
They left through a passageway in your own home, and they didn't tell you where they were going?
Your officers and soldiers were following them. Why did they not arrest them?
You helped them flee, so you are an accomplice. Furthermore, the idiocy of my guards does not absolve you of your crimes.
I am merely Maximilian's wife, and his actions are his business, not mine.
Maximilian will no longer have a wife, since there will be no Maximilian to speak of.
For now, he has escaped your incompetence. You can continue your nonsense when you find him.
You can be certain that if we do not find him, you will be held responsible and crucified in his place. That is, unless you can tell us where his hideout is.
I do not know where they are. And you can do whatever you see fit.
You are misusing my fatherly mercy. Helen!
Let her go, Your Highness. She is good bait for luring Maximilian.
Calm down, Your Highness. Women follow the religion of their husbands. Let time pass. A new husband will guide her.
Put her under house surveillance.
Yes, Your Highness. Of course.
What news, my lady?
They haven't found them yet. Thank God.
Thank God. So, why are you so unhappy?
Julius being so foul tortures me even more than my father does. Dear God, help protect him from his enemies wherever he is.